Hello everyone, today we'll start with the next chapter in computer, that is GIMP, Introduction to Tools. Now what is GIMP? GIMP, it is the acronym for GNU Image Manipulation Program. GNU Image Manipulation Program. Now why do we use this GIMP? You have studied Tux Paint in your lower classes. So what do you do over there? You make paintings, make images, right? So here also, what can you do? You can make images and you can edit images, in short. You do editing in your mobile phones, right? Of your photos and all. So GIMP, it is an image manipulation program. That is, you can make changes in the photo or image. That is photo retouching, image composition. Image composition means what? To make an image and image construction. Its features are same as Adobe Photoshop. You have used Photoshop? Most of you have used Photoshop. So it is same, the features are same. Or else Corel, Photo Paint. All these features are same. Now let's start with this GIMP. Let's study about the screen. What is there? What are the parts of the screen? So the first thing over here that you can see on your left side, this is the toolbox where you have different tools. Tools to select the this image or do whatever changes you want to do. These are the tools you will do using these tools. Then the next is over here. This is tool options. Now what do you mean by this tool option? Now suppose if I select this zoom tool. So zoom tool is selected. So whatever is related to the zoom tool, the options will be displayed over here. Then this, the center part, the screen, this is known as the image window. Whenever you open an image or photo to edit or do whatever you want to do, it will be shown over here. It's like your workspace. You will work over here on the image. So this is the image window. Then on the right side over here, you have layers dialog. Can you see this layers? This is layers dialog. Now you have different layers in your this image. The background is there. Then front image is there. So you have different layers, na? So this is the layers window. Then over here down you have, see, brushes, pattern and gradient. See, brushes. This is pattern dialog and this is gradient. We'll study all these things in detail later. Now, here you have docking dialogs. What do you mean by docking dialogs? Now, suppose you can shift the places of this dialog box. You can place it as you want. Now, suppose this tool options is there, na? I want a separate dialog box over here. So, what will I do? I will click, drag and put over here. See, similarly if I want this gradients over here, see, click, drag and put it over here. Gradients is shifted over here. Again, if you want to add it over here, here you have option, add tab, gradient. See, and for your tools option, what will we do? If we want to put it back over there, just click, drag and drop over here. This is known as docking dialogs. What do you mean by docking dialogs? You can place the dialog box anywhere you want. You can place it according to you. There is no restriction that this dialog box will come over here only, this will come over here only. You can place it according to you. So this is known as docking dialogs. Now next we will study is the toolbox. The tools in the toolbox. See over here. Now These tools are there in the toolbox. What is all these tools? We'll study. See, there it is divided in some parts. Over here, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this 7. Till here, this is the selection tools. These are the selection tools. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We'll study in detail in the next video, but for now remember this are the selection tools. Then the next, from here, this till here, it is the transform tool. These are the transform tool. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. These are the transform tools. Then paint tools. Paint tools start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. These are all the paint tools. And over here you have foreground and background color. You can change the foreground and background color. So this toolbox, it is divided in four parts. First is the selection tools, then transform tools, then paint tool and foreground and background colors. We'll study all these tools in detail in the next video. Thank you.